गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट सम न्यू कंसेप्ट ऑफ एसी, द पीक एवरेज एंड आरएमएस वैल्यू। इन यस्टरडे क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस हाउ द ईएमएफ विल इंड्यूस एंड टुडे वी विल सी व्हाट इज द इक्वेशन ऑफ इंड्यूस ईएमएफ। We have seen, because here we have two magnets here and it is the coil which was starting in this direction and then it is rotating by the theta angle, and this coil has the area is A and have number of turns, let us suppose capital N, and omega is the angular speed or velocity. So that in this condition, according to Faraday's laws, the induced EMF is given by the change of rate of change of the flux. So we can write this flux here, and you can see this, it is the maximum flux, and it is the condition when the plane, because if I am, let us suppose my coil is here, so is the plane is perpendicular to this, so in this direction the field direction and the area both are the parallel, or you can say the plane of coil is perpendicular to the flux line. In this case we have the maximum flux, and when the plane of coil is parallel to flux lines, it means in this condition the flux will be zero. So the flux will maximum will here and zero will in the direction. So at any angle I can write my flux is this, and this becomes equal to this, then we can differentiate it and you will. So this is our equation which we yesterday we mentioned E equal to, or you can say V equal to E M maximum value, which we will call it is the peak value of the induced EMF, and it is the sinusoidal behavior. According to this you can calculate here the sinusoidal behavior of the current. Here you see the our voltage will vary like in this way, but you can see the flux will vary in this, because at the theta equal to zero and that condition our induced EMF is zero, but our flux is maximum. You can see from this figure here, is it okay? So this is the EMF equation here. Some important aspect when we are talking about the AC, phase and phase difference is very important. So you must understand the concept of these two. If I am talking about the phase, it means it is nothing but the fractional part of a cycle through which the alternating quantity has advanced from the reference point. Let us suppose we are taking this reference point and then we are advanced from this particular point to this particular point. So the phase at any instant which I am mentioning here, let us suppose we are here at the time t, from the instant where the time was zero. So let us suppose first we were at this position, first we were here and now we are here. So in this condition our phase is given by the t at the instant time t divided by the total time, which we are saying the time period for the alternating quantity. So that will be the phase here. If you are talking about the phase angle, then it is defined as the phase measure in terms of the angle, and that is given by the omega t, and omega is nothing but 2 pi upon t, okay, and this is basically measured in the radian, and it is also known as the electrical angle. In yesterday class I have discussed about what is the meaning of electrical angle and mechanical angle, and you must know about the 2 pi radian is equal to 360 degree. This you must also know, because when you will calculate the value, that time it is required. And if you are talking about the phase difference, you can see here these are in the in phase and here you can see the out phase. So when the phase difference between two alternating quantity, whether is the voltage or you can say the current, it may be voltage or it may be current. So that's why I'm saying the phase difference between two alternating quantities having same frequency is the difference of the phase at maxima, or you can say is the zero or minima of the two alternating quantity. So you can see is the phase difference here, and it is, you can say, in the phase. And here you see here this one quantity and two quantity, but both are the out of phase. So that is the terminology which we will use when we will solve our numerical problems. Now the peak value. Peak value is nothing but the maximum value of alternating quantity, whether it's the voltage and current attendant in a complete cycle, is called the peak value. So if I'm talking about from this up, then it is the peak value. Or you can say if I'm talking about the even, then it is the peak value. So it is the meaning of peak value. Then I'm talking about the second is the average value, and the average of all instantaneous values of an alternating quantity over one cycle is called as the average value of that quantity. So let us suppose I am using here mid-orient method here, mid-orient method I am using here, and you can see I divide my AC cycle into n parts and putting I1, I2, I3 and up to n, up to point n I am putting my current here. So the average value is nothing but the mean of mid ordinates divided by, so I will take this mean of this value. Then if instantaneous value of periodic function is changing continuously, then the average value, because you see from any of graph the value is continuously changing. First I am taking this one value I1, then here I2, then here I3, then here I4, then here I5, I6, I7, let us suppose up to IN. So I am using like this way. So this continuously changing value, then the average value of periodic function during time is defined by this 1 by TT is thus one complete cycle time, 0 to function divided by T. The time function is expressed in term of the angle. So that's why we can write theta equal to omega T. And from this, you can write our average value like this way. So that value which I'm mentioning here, I1, I2, I3, I4, I5, I6 every time, and it is continuously changed. So that continuously changed value in I can express in the average function using this formula. Is it okay? And omega t is the 2 pi. So the average is nothing but the area under the curve divided by the length of the base of the curve. That is the concept behind here. So now I will calculate the average value of alternating current or voltage over a complete cycle. It means I want to calculate my average value from this to this. So if I'm talking about the half cycle, then I will take this. So I will cover the area under this and the base length is pi. But if I'm considering my complete cycle here, then the base length becomes 2 pi and I have to take care about this one and this one also. So because these are the voltage and current value, and if I want to write the average value, so in last slide we defined a function, the average value. So I'm taking the current here, so I put this value, and because this current is given by this, so put this value, and this putting this value, it's a very simple integration formula. I do this and then I will get this value. So what you see here, it is equal to 0. This value is equal to 0. So this value becomes equal to 0. And similarly, you can see the average voltage value also becomes equal to 0. I will again put the value of voltage here and do so. The same mathematics is here, so it becomes equal to 0. So it means this one and this one, it is in plus positive half and it is minus negative half. So this average value over complete cycle becomes equal to 0. So now I have to take care about for a half cycle. Why I'm taking about this? Because if we are taking the average value of a symmetrical wave for a complete cycle, then it becomes equal to zero, where half positive cycle is exactly equal to the half negative side. That's it becomes equal to zero. But for some purposes, a non-zero average value of an alternating current relates to the average rate of flow of the charge during a complete cycle. Therefore, a non-zero average value is defined as, so I am defining this value again, the average formula I am using here. And what now I am doing, I am whether I am calculating for this zero to this, or I am calculating from zero to t by 2 to t. So that average value formula is same formula I am using here, but what I am doing here, I am converting my zero to t by 2. So I am considering this one half circle, and then to calculate this value, and this average value becomes equal to 2 pi and 2 I maximum upon pi, and is equal to this. So that is average values applicable AC when we want to relate the average rate of flow of charge during a complete cycle. So that condition we require non-zero value, and that non-zero value we are calculating in this way. So now what we are taking, now we are not bothering about this half circle, negative half circle, we are not bothered about this. It means we are defining this average value first, when this one and then this one. So this becomes equal to the average value, and this average value is given by maximum of this. Now we will discuss here the root mean square value, and we call RMS value. This wavefront of current I draw here because I will take the square of this. That's why I'm doing. And I'm defined here the base, because when I want to take the average, then I will take the area and divide it by the base length. So if I'm talking about the half cycle, then it's become pi. And if you are talking about the full cycle, then it becomes equal to 2 pi. So the mean value of square of alternating quantity, voltage or current, over a full cycle is called as the mean square value. And the square root of the mean square value is called root mean square value. And this value is also known as the effective value or virtual value. So I will taking again here the current value. We can take voltage value also here and put this, and the square becomes equal to. So first I will take the mean square of instantaneous values of current in complete cycle. So I choose this complete cycle. It means I'm coming from this to this. I'm choosing this complete cycle here. We are taking this, and 2 pi is the base length here. From 0 to 2 pi, that's why we are putting this value. And we are, it means here we are taking sine current square, so the square is becomes equal to this. We have the positive magnitude for the both of cycles here, and then I will take the square root of this, and it is nothing but the RMS value. So I put these values here, my square value is here, and then put this relation here and calculate. It's a very simple mathematics, and what I get value here, IRMS equal to this is equal to nothing but it's 0.707 IR. This is 0.70 IR. So the IRMS is equal to the maximum value multiplied by this. From these values, peak values, average value, and RMS value, we can define two type of the factor. One is the form factor. Form factor is nothing but RMS value divided by the average value. So for a sinusoidal wave, we have both the values. So this becomes equal to 1.11. And the peak factor is defined by the peak value divided by the RMS value. And again, we know the values for the sinusoidal wave, and it becomes equal to 1.414. So the form factor and the peak factor both give an identification, or you can see the indication of the shape of the wave function. So that is the meaning of form factor and peak factor, because they give an indication of the shape of the waveform. The more sharper the peak of the wave, the higher is the value of these factors. That is the meaning of this. So this is all about the peak and average and RMS value. I think you understood the concept of these values. In next class, we will see the physical significance of the RMS value and then the phasor concept of alternating quantities. If you have any problem, then you can call me or write a mail on sham@gawc.ac.in. Thank you. Stop.